So welcome back to the LTE Air Interface Training. Now let's talk about the PLMN selection and cell selection process. So there is a certain priority given to different PLMN, like the highest priority is for the home PLMN, then there are equivalent home PLMN, and then there are other foreign PLMN which are selected when I use my user equipment abroad in a foreign country. So first of all, the information of the PLMN selection is implemented in the USIM card, so programmed by the operator, but the PLMN selection can be influenced also by the user, so he can in abroad select a certain PLMN. Then he measures high quality cells are distinguished from low priority cells. The high priority cells are all cells where the RSRP value is above -110 dBm. And these are equivalent with respect to the receive level. So there is the rankings then only done on the PLMN or combination of PLMN and radio access technology. So, but we focus on LTE, so we only care here about the PLMN itself. So if there is no home PLMN and no equivalent home PLMN, then first are selected PLMNs with high quality, so with a RSRP value below above -110 dBm. And if there are no high quality networks, then the user equipment selects PLMN according to the RSRP value. So the next step is the cell selection. The cell selection parameter are given in the system information. And for this, we have the so-called S criteria, which has to be fulfilled. The S is calculated from the receive level, and we subtract the minimum receive level which is accepted in the cell. So this makes sure that the cell can only be selected if the receive level is above the minimum threshold. And then there is some offset given, a positive offset, and this is used during periodically looking for the home PLMN network. So if the user equipment is attached to a foreign network, then the system from time to time checks if the home PLMN network is available, and then this network will be prioritized by this factor. And then we have a power compensation factor, which is seldomly relevant. This is only relevant for low power class user equipment, so this means we have now only one power class, 23 dBm maximum power. So there is no power compensation, but if there may be some lower power class mobile, so like a mobile which only has a maximum power of 20 dBm, then there will be an offset given of 3 dBm. So the level has to be 3 dB higher than for a high power user equipment. There is also a reselection or cell selection rule regarding the quality of the level, so based on the RSRQ value. This was introduced in the 3GPP release 9 version. So we know that this is dependent on the traffic in the cell, so it decreases with increasing resource block usage. So this makes it more probable that a low-loaded cell will be selected. So the parameters which define the cell selection are listed here. I've already explained them. The receive level, then the minimum receive level, offset, power compensation, and the maximum power, which is allowed in the cell. So thank you for watching.